excited. Welcome back to our channel. Good morning. We're just arriving to Disney World. We had a long day of travel yesterday, as usually goes, going coast to coast. But an early morning, got up about 5 o'clock and had an 8 o'clock flight. Went nonstop to Orlando and then had to make a pit stop at Walmart, get to the hotel, rent our car, which of course we got suckered into upgrading to a Mustang. But
nice car.
How that goes. So anyway, we're looking forward to today. There's a couple of our must-dos. We're trying to get into the Space 220 restaurant or lounge. Either one we'd be happy with. We'll see if it happens. And then the new Remy Ratatouille ride is our priority. So we might be waiting a while on that one. We'll see what happens. I'm having trouble getting the fast pass. So anyway, here we go.
We are in line for Spaceship Earth. And we're waiting for our reservation. We just got reservations to get into the Space 220 restaurant. So
yeah, we're excited about that one.
That was half the reason we came here. So yep. We're looking forward to it.
So we just got into Space 220, and we're waiting for our transport to the restaurant, and they gave us this.
It's our boarding pass.
Boarding pass. So.
Uh-oh, they're calling us.
I wish I weren't scared of heights.
You're ready to board the Mark 5 Star Bear. Permanent space elevator. SK2, yes. We're on our final approach. Roger that. If you look above, you'll see Centauri Space Station coming into view. Once we dock, gather your belongings and exit through the open airlock. A Space 220 agent will be waiting for you.
Surface. If you look around, you can see a lot of optional places flying by.
Space 220
Space
220.
So, we're in outer space, huh?
Yep, we're in outer space.
So, I got the calamari. And Andy got the space greens. It has cranberries, pecans,
bears.
Apple cider, pears. Say bears? Looks good.
There's a guy like he's snowboarding.
Come back. For entrees, I got the roasted chicken. And Andy got the flat iron steak. With potatoes and green beans. So you had the steak that had a coffee crust.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It did have a coffee crust. Didn't taste like coffee at all.
The funny thing is when you first got your meal, I tasted the chicken, I thought it was delicious. And then I got my steak and I started eating it, and it was very, very good. And then when I went back to your chicken, it didn't taste so good. So I don't know if it was all this full or I was just used to the taste of the steak. I don't know what it was, but anyway, it was a delicious meal.
Yeah, so it's a fixed price, and you get one appetizer and one entree.
Yeah.
Special treat.
And that's what we did.
To eat 220 miles above the earth.
Yep. Strangely enough, everything still tastes the same.
These are the 50th anniversary golden statues. They put all over all the four parks. All over the four parks. So we found the Rocket and Groot.
Rocket and Groot.
So I did also fail to mention that we're here during the Festival of the Arts. So they have all kinds of neat food booths all over the park, as well as like art booths as well. We can buy Disney themed art. This is the newest ride here at Disney World. It's the Remy's Ratatouille ride. And I couldn't get a fast pass, but looks like we're just getting in the standby line and we're just gonna have to wait.
Yes, but what to prepare? Huh? Pour de votre idea? Coco vin? No. A simple omelet? Too simple.
What?
Mais oui, that's it!
Good time here
in Epcot,
Disneyland.
We're about halfway around World Showcase.
Studios.
We just watched the Disney on Broadway series that you just saw a clip of. Anyway.
Yep.
Having a good time.
It's been fun. It's been fun. Yeah, it's very nice. Weather. The sun just went down and it is starting to get cold. It gets cold quickly here.
You can see the pretty sunset behind us, the pink sky. It's so pretty.
And the big silver ball.
Spaceship Earth.
Okay, that one too. All right. Wish you were here.
Come on, let's go and play. Elsa wants to give us all some fun. She's making everyone a snow summer day.
Well, we're heading out for the night. We had a great time at Epcot today. It was a perfect Epcot day. I thoroughly enjoyed every minute of it, but...
Very good. Nice day.
Late. Park's closing. We're heading out till tomorrow.
9 p.m.
See you then.
Okay, bye.
Good morning.
Hello there.
We're at Hollywood Studios today. And we have a packed day because we're going to spend a few hours here and then we're going to go over to Magic Kingdom for the rest of the day. So it should be a good time. We're looking forward today here going on Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, which, say that five times fast, is one of the newest rides. Well, I think it is the newest ride here. And then also Slinky Dog Dash is one that we have not got to go on before, so we're going to be going on that. So we're at the 50s Prime Time Cafe, and it's just gonna be home cooking for lunch, so we'll see. So I ordered the pot roast, although I managed to mush it all up before I started my video, so it looked prettier than that. And then Andy got the sampler.
Yep.
Show us what you got.
Here's the chicken, meatloaf, and roast beef.
Okay, you tried some so far?
Yeah, the roast beef is really good.
Can't wait to dig in. Well, we're heading out from Hollywood Studios. Mildly successful. We got to do lunch, rock and roller coaster. That was fun.
I love that ride.
Damn. We walked through the Galaxy's Edge just to compare, and Toy Story Land. I really wanted to do Slinky Dog Dash, but it was almost a 2-hour wait, and Tower of Terror we also want to do, which was also a 2-hour wait. So
we can do Tower of Terror at home. And we did Toy Story Land when we were in Hong Kong, so we had an idea what that was.
Yeah, and we just did Runaway Railway, which you'll see behind us in the clips that you just saw. So anyway, heading over to Magic Kingdom.
Well, we're on another cruise ship. Unfortunately, this is just the crummy little one that takes you from the parking lot. The parking lot is way back there, and then you take this ferry all the way over to there. It's a mile away. Disneyland is a mile away from the parking lot, so you either have to take the monorail or you have to take this ferry. So we're taking the ferry for the way in and the monorail for the way out, but that's kind of interesting that it's that far away. So we're on our way to the Magic Kingdom, and I have no idea why, but I'm sure April has something.
Well, my number one goal today is to go on the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, which is a ride we do not have in California, so that's why I want to ride that ride. But it's a long wait, and so far I have not been able to secure a fast pass, so we shall see. line for the People Mover. For all of us old school Disney people, we remember that we had that in California Disneyland for years.
Yeah.
But
apparently it moves people.
They took it out back when I was a kid, so I'm kind of excited to be able to go on it again.
Step onto the moving platform with caution and exit by stepping away from the car.
Well, we're heading out for the night from the Magic Kingdom. We never made it on Mine Train. I have some thoughts about some of this that I'll share later. And we just finished the fireworks show, which I think I might save for the very end of the video because it's just that good. So, anyhow, we're heading out for the night. Tomorrow we're heading to Animal Kingdom. So,
there's a light on the building over there that keeps shining on us, so that's why we keep lighting up and then pouring out light into the darkness. So, anyway.
But we had a good time here
today. If you were wondering, that's why that's happening. So. Yeah, we had a nice time. Nice time.
All right, good night.
Bye.
Good morning.
Hello there.
We are at Animal Kingdom today, last park on the list. And we have been able to get a fast pass for Flight of Passage. I'm shocked that it worked, but super, super excited. So that's actually our first stop.
Yeah, and I'm all Dramamined up and Bonined up, and I got drops behind my ears, and I got pressure things on my wrists. I'm attempting to do this ride and not puke when I get off.
Hopefully, and you can keep your eyes open.
Yeah, I'm really gonna try and keep my eyes open. I hate not being able to ride rides anymore, but we'll see. I've done everything possible. If I can't do it now, it's never gonna happen.
Yeah. Expedition Everest is closed for refurbishment, so sadly we won't be able to ride that, although Andy was kind of on the fence with that one anyway, so.
Because it goes backwards.
Kind of solves that problem, so. Anyway, looking forward to a nice day. So we're having lunch at Yak and Yeti, and Andy got the ribs and french fries, and I got the chicken tikka masala, which is kind of one of their specialties. It's supposed to be very good, so I'm looking forward to that. And then I didn't get to ask you about your experience on Flight of Passage.
Well, it turned out to be okay. It's kind of nice. I did close my eyes just a little bit of it when it was like really crazy, bouncy, flying through the air type stuff. But for the great, great, great majority of it, I had my eyes open and I thoroughly enjoyed it. Never got sick afterwards, so it was a great success.
Yeah, glad about that.
Yeah.
Heading out for the day. Well, yeah, for the trip. But
no more Disneyland.
Yeah, we were able to go on our favorite ride here, which is Flight of Passage. See, I can't even think anymore. And we got to see Festival of the Lion King. We didn't do Navi River. Can we go on the pavement? Yeah. Because it was an hour wait, which isn't too terrible, but we're kind of tired to wait an hour, and we did that ride last time we were here, so we're skipping it. And we're both sufficiently caffeinated, coffee and Monster, and so I'm not sure what we're gonna do. We're trying to use up our tank of gas in our rental car because we prepaid for the gas and we'd like to use it up.
So. Well, we didn't know. It's such a ripoff. I'm so angry about it because they say, do you want to prepay gas? So I just thought that meant that when you come back in, they fill up the tank with whatever it is that, you know, they have for gas there, and then they tell you how much that is. But apparently, when you say you prepay for gas, it means they charge you the equivalency of a tank full of gas. So
whether you use it or not.
Yeah, it was $70 for gas, and there is, you know, we're going to use maybe 20 at the most. We're trying to use as much as we can. We've only used a quarter of a tank of gas, but we're paying for an entire tank. And you know how cheap I am, so that's just killing me. I'm thinking about just leaving the car running in the hotel parking lot tonight all night.
We considered driving to Daytona Beach just to check it out. It's about an hour away, but as we come out of the parks, we're like, I think we're too tired for this, so.
Yeah.
So anyway, just a couple thoughts on their new Genie Plus, which is the new version of the Fast Pass. Challenges with it. Yesterday, I couldn't get anything I wanted for the good rides. Managed it a couple other times, so I don't know, it's maybe 50-50, but it's a little bit frustrating when I feel when you come from so far away across the country and then you spend all this money to get into the park and then you can't even ride the ride you want to ride without waiting for 2 hours. It's a little bit frustrating, but am I going to come back? Yes, I will.
We should have a special line for people who came across the country and spent a lot of money to get tickets to get in there.
Just saying. So anyway, we're going to make a couple pit stops on the way back to the hotel. Probably have an early night. We're heading out in the morning for our Bahama cruise. So we're going to make a separate video for that. So stay tuned. Anything else you want to add?
Bye.
See you in the next one, everybody. Bye-bye.